Hello dear students, in this practical video we are going to learn about fruit processing. Now as we all know that fruits are mostly seasonal and so we get them to in only one season only particularly. So it's very important that we process the fruit and preserve them so that we can have them throughout the year. One such fruit is mango. So mango is a seasonal fruit and we get it only during a particular season. And so in this practical video we are going to learn how to preserve mango by making jam. So in this video we are going to learn step by step how to make mango jam at household level without addition of any preservative.
To process fruits we are taking mango. Mango is now seasonally available and we can make mango jam out of it. First of all, in order to make mango jam we will take the mango and wash it. After washing, we will now peel it and make pulp out of it.
Wash the mango thoroughly so that there is no dirt and dust left. After washing, we will peel the mangoes and take out the pulp from it. After peeling, we can pulp out the mango. Now the different methods how we can pulp the mango, we can also use the grinder if required. Since the mango which I have taken is very ripe and can be pulped very easily, I am using the peeler to get the flesh and after that I will use the masher to mash it into a fine pulp.
Now you can see that using a masher I have taken out the mango pulp. Now here you can see that there are some strains, so I will sieve it and make it into a fine pulp. Now we are straining it so that we get the fine pulp in order to make jam. So this is the fine mango pulp which we get after mashing the mango. Now we will weigh this mango pulp and then take sugar and cook them to make into jelly. Now what is the main difference between jam and jelly? Jam and jelly both are made up of fruits, but the prime difference between jam and jelly is in the jam we take the entire pulp and the juice, whereas in jelly gelatin formation is very much necessary. Since because of that we take only the juice and not the pulp, we strain the product and take the juice in order to make jelly. We will weigh the pulp and according to the weight of the pulp we will take the sugar. Here we can see that the vessel is already 500 gram. Now we will add the pulp and see the weight of the pulp. As we can see in the ball, we have 175 gram of pulp and we have taken equal amount of sugar. Generally while making jam we take 1:1 pulp and sugar. There is another way of counting the sugar that is required for making jam, that is calculation by the TSS. With the help of that we count the amount of sugar which is required. This is a rather easy way of taking the sugar. We take it in equal amount with that of the pulp. Now we will proceed with the cooking and making of jam. The TSS of jam is 65 degree Brix. We will heat the pulp in a pan and we can see that the pulp is heated. Now we will add the sugar which we have already weighed little by little and mix it and cook it for some while. See that the jam is cooking. This way we will cook it for some time until we get the desired consistency. Now, how do we get the desired consistency, or how do we judge the end point of jam? In order to judge the end point of the jam, we do generally two tests. That is, we do a droplet test with the help of a water, and another one is we can use the hand refractometer to see the TSS of the jam. If the TSS is 65 to 68, that means we have got the jam in a correct point. Similarly, in the droplet test also, if it gives a droplet which does not spread in water, that means we have received the endpoint of the jam. So this way we will cook until we get the endpoint of the jam. Now we will judge the endpoint of the jam. As we can see that it is setting at the bottom very nicely, that means we have received the desired endpoint. If the endpoint, this is the final product, our jam, which we have made. Now we will let this cool and then put it into glass bottles. Now, in order to see the TSS, we will use a refractometer. So we will take the jam and put one drop of it. Close it. It is 64 degree Brix. The desired degree Brix for jam is around 65, so it is almost the desired amount of TSS. So now you can see that this is the jam and it is cool. Now after cooling, we will put them into the sterilized bottle. We have already sterilized the bottle, and now we'll put the contents into the bottle. So we have finished bottling of the product. Now this product can be kept for a very long duration of time. As compared to the mango pulp, the fresh mango pulp can be stored only for one day, whereas when we make it into jam, this jam without adding any preservative can be taken for 2 to 3 months. So this way we can preserve fruit and vegetable by simple method of processing. Thank you.